with Charlie, have a little talk today about trees, if anybody's interested. Anybody notice anything interesting about these trees here? Do you notice anything? Know what that is? That is the oldest tree in the world. It's a bristlecone pine. 5,000 years old. 5,000 years old. This one, look how wide that is. That's the General Sherman tree. It's 11 metres in diameter. 11 metres, that's like from walking to here. Right to the Christian there. 11 metres in diameter. You see all those people. General Sherman, biggest tree in the world by sheer volume. But this one, this is called Hyperion. It's the tallest tree in the world. 380 feet tall. It's an amazing tree. Anybody spot this one though? I bet you all recognise this tree. Do you recognise this tree, sir? Have you seen that before? Let me give you a bit of a hint. What about you, madam? You probably won't recognise that tree. I need someone a bit younger. This gentleman here, he'll recognise. Just come around here, sir. We'll look at this tree. Where have you seen that tree before? So I'll give you a little bit of a clue. In the background there. Who are these guys? It's U2. Look, it's Bono, Adam, Larry, the H. Yeah, it's U2, isn't it? It's from the album, The Joshua Tree. You know, and they sung some great songs on it. Like, I still haven't found what I'm looking for. Well, we're talking today about five trees that you need to know. And this is one of the trees that you need to know. This one here. See that? That is the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Have you ever heard of that tree before? The tree of the knowledge? No? Well, it's the one in the Garden of Eden. Do you remember God said, don't eat from that tree?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? And they ate of the tree and they were banished from the Garden of Eden, didn't they? Yeah. But what they did was, when they first ate of it and their eyes were opened and they realised they were naked, then they hid from God and they were hiding from it. So they hid behind a bush, right? That was the tree of hiding. And I think a lot of people, after they've done things wrong, they try and hide the wrong things, don't they, that they've done. And they try and pretend that it didn't happen. That's what they were doing. They were hiding from God. All right, hiding, that's the tree of hiding. But you know, we've all done things wrong, right? We've all broken God's law, just might have been here. And we all try and hide our sin. But one person had heard about Jesus, and his name was Zacchaeus. And he went into a tree, just like this, a sycamore tree. This is a sycamore gap at Hadrian's Wall, if you've ever been up there. It's a beautiful little, everyone takes photos of it, you know, the little dip there between Hadrian's Wall. And he went up the sycamore tree, but like this did Zacchaeus. And he went up there because he'd heard about all these amazing things that Jesus had done. And he wanted to see Jesus for himself. So he was out there looking. I can't see Jesus, and I see a crowd in front of me. So he climbed up a tree instead, the sycamore tree. And then when Jesus came past, he could see him. Like, there's Jesus. Then Jesus stopped and he looked up into the tree. And he said, Zacchaeus, come down. I want to come to your house for tea. So he went to his house for tea. And at that moment, Zacchaeus was so overcome with all the wrong things that he'd done. Decided to change his life completely. It was a tax collector, he only decided to do. He sold half of his possessions, gave them to the poor, and then if he robbed anybody of any money, he gave them back four times as much as what he took. That's the tree of seeking. Now, I don't know about you today, you might be one of these people who's seeking for answers, looking for the answers. Well, tell me what the answer is. It's in this tree. It's the tree of Calvary. Right? The tree of Calvary is the cross that Jesus died on. It's the piece of wood that Jesus was nailed to. And at that cross there, we sin to begin with. You come to Jesus and we can say, Jesus, forgive me of all the wrong things I've done. I'm hiding no longer. I'm seeking you. And I come to the cross for salvation. If you say, you know, Jesus, forgive me, when you become a Christian, then one day there's a fig tree that you'll be entitled to. It's the tree in heaven. And it's the tree of life. Right? The tree of life in heaven, which is amazing, isn't it? And we're in trouble today because we want everybody to come to know the hope that we have, because we've got an amazing hope. We wake up in the morning, you're aching, you're tired, you've opened the curtains, you see the sun shining, you remember you're saved, you remember that your sins are forgiven, you remember that you're going to live forever because of what Jesus did on the cross. Right? And that's the beautiful message of hope that we have today for people in Charlie. So if that's something that you'd like to get to know, please do take a leaflet. There are loads of leaflets here that you can pass out. So good news. So please do take a leaflet. Thank you very much for listening.
I've never heard of that before. It's good. The way you've explained it, if you know.
You like that, yeah?
Yeah, that was good. That's the first time it's ever been explained.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
That.
Well, this is what
I understood
like
it that way.
Yeah,
maybe
yeah.
Come out with some jargon and stuff.
Yeah.
I do understand it the way you've done it that way.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, do you believe in God? And if you have any kind of faith or anything like that?
I don't know.
No. What's madness in the world, isn't there? There's a lot of evil.
More evil now than what there's ever been when we were here. At one time, you could walk across your door and have no one. I won't even come out my door once it's gone dark. Because I've been killed twice. Once it's gone dark, I think I don't want it.
But to me, the presence of, like, you know, the evidence of evil in the world, to me, is golden. Because, you know, if there's so much badness in the world, then, you know, there must be God as well. Because, number one, we recognise badness, because, oh, that's bad, that's bad. But where does that idea of badness come from? Other than, you know, if we were just a collection of molecules and just exploding into existence from, like, nothing, then we would just be stuck. We wouldn't have a sense of, like, right and wrong, would we? But we've got a sense of right and wrong because God is present. And the other reason I think we believe supreme God is because if there's evil in the world, then there must be a devil behind it all. Yeah? Now, if there's a devil, surely there must be a God.
Oh, yeah, I do believe in it.
That is the way you've done that. That's why I'm not going to